Alu bacho chola bacho bacho bakurani bacho na bandhu tomar chokhe moni.
This group does not need any discussion on the fact that development today is a form of violence. It's extremely destructive. It's violence against nature, violence against ourselves as individuals, against communities, against cultures, against humanity, and so on. And so therefore, possibly the most important task before human beings and for all of the rest of creation is to find alternatives, fundamental alternatives to this form of development. Just to say that often when we do a search for alternatives or for solutions to the problems we have, for instance on environment we talk about switching off the lights when we are leaving the room or recycling the waste that we are producing and things like that, which is of course all very important, but it doesn't tackle the root causes of the problems that we have. So essentially what we are talking about is that if the problems we have are rooted in factors like the concentration of power in the hands of capitalists or capitalism itself, in the hands of the state, so what some people call statism, in the hands of men, so patriarchy, in the hands of some caste, so casteism, or any other such, you know, racism, etc., any other such basic roots that we can think of, then the search for alternatives is a search for alternatives to these fundamental factors. And what we are trying to do is to see where all are the kinds of activities that are happening which are trying to address these root problems. So essentially, one of the objectives of this whole process is that people who are doing this kind of wonderful work, many of whom are represented here, are not often able to meet together. People who are doing resistance are able to meet together more, or we do meet together more, and that's very important. It still needs to happen. But those who are working on alternatives, maybe there isn't that much of a meeting ground, that much of a platform available for us to meet together. And especially across sectors, people who work on agriculture, for instance, do have. There is a National Alliance on Sustainable Agriculture. People who work on gender justice, maybe there are alliances where people can meet. Those who are working on health or public health, for instance, are able to meet. But cutting across sectors and seeing the interconnections between health and agriculture and gender and environment and conservation and education and so on, that does not happen often enough, where we can talk to each other, say, this is what I'm doing, this is what you're doing, maybe we can work together, maybe I can learn from you, you can learn from me, to strengthen the whole alternatives sector and movement itself. So that is one of the main reasons why this process of Vikalp Sangam was started. Another major objective is to is collective visioning, which is to say that in all the places that you're working in, you have your own vision of what you want the world to be. People have their own vision of what they want, maybe several visions of what they want the world to be. How could it be different from what it is now? And that wisdom, that conceptualization, that I would say even theorization that comes from the grassroots, from the bottom up, from those who are working in the field, the idea of Vikalp Sangam is also to try and put that together and see, can we then collectively emerge with some sort of a vision, a broad vision, which doesn't make us rigidly stuck to some ideology, but is very broad about principles and values, broad enough for us, each of us, to identify with it and give us some kind of a anchoring of a conceptual and ideological anchoring which can take our work further. So out of the Sangam process, we have come up with this discussion note, which we have put on the table in English and Hindi. There are other languages also available, which is, up till now, the 12 Sangams that have happened, the kind of collective thinking that we have. And it will keep evolving. It's not a static process. You keep evolving. We can use it in different ways. For instance, the youth Sangam that happened, one of the ideas was, how do we convert something like that into a youth vision for the future of India? The third and final objective of the Vikalp Sangam process is that, can this process give us the political strength and create the political mass to affect change at a political level, which does not mean fighting elections. It means actually being able to become strong enough to be able to affect the way the government works, to even affect the structure of the government, to even start questioning things like what is government and what is governance, what is the state, what is a nation, and things like that. So that's the third major objective. So just quickly to mention which of the Sangams have already happened. This is the 13th and luckiest Sangam. We've had 12 so far. 8 of them have been regional, and I've already given you the names of the co-organizers. I won't repeat them, but they have been held in Andhra, Telangana, Kerala, Maharashtra, Ladakh, Kutch, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Western Himalaya. And there have been 4 thematic sanghams, 2 of them on food and 1 on energy and 1 a youth Vikalp Sangam which was held in Bhopal. So these are the sanghams that have been held so far, but apart from the sanghams, the process also involves, the process also involves a lot of documentation, and outreach. So for instance, we now have a Vikalp Sangam website has about 750 stories of initiatives around India, which include a lot of what you people are doing. So that's quite, in just in 3 years, 750. Now we know that 750 is a big number, but it's actually the tip of the iceberg. There are thousands of stories out there. So we want more and more and more of these stories coming in any language, not only English, Hindi, but in any language coming into the website. So one is this documentation and outreach. And the outreach also happens in the form of things like this poster exhibition, the booklets which are available in the stall over there, and in other forms, and now films. So we're very privileged that video volunteers and Srishti School of Art have helped to do, by the end of this year, there will be 80 films on initiatives that they would have put together. And they're doing it on absolute shoestring budgets, which we get complaints about.
So, basically that's it. This Sangam, why are we here? Briefly, I think Manish and Ravi mentioned already. But the idea was that after having done these 3 years, and also after having learnt, and Joy has very well, very welcome remark in the morning that it's not just these 3 years. We've all been part of, or many of us have been part of, a much longer process of churning and resistance and creating alternatives. So the idea of this Sangam is, what have we learnt so far? Of all that we've been doing, what has worked, what has not worked, and what can we do more and better in the next few years? And differently, better.
Alu bachu chola bachu, bachu bakur kani, bachu na bundu, bachu bimuni.